Hey everybody, Jill here. Today I'm going to introduce you to an analytics tool called Clicky. But first I want to cover analytics real quick. I know there's a lot of controversy over the transfer of the universal analytics to GA4. As someone who's very involved in analytics on a daily basis, I can tell you I hate GA4, as do many other people as well. So a lot of people are looking for alternatives to their tracking that is much easier to set up and just use easily. If you log into your analytics and you're seeing this, okay, this means what it says. As of July 1st, if you have Universal Analytics as your only analytics, you will lose data, okay, which means it won't acquire any new data after July 1st. You'll still have access to your old data for a little while. We're not sure how long yet. Originally, they said we would have the old data for a year. A lot of people think it might be longer. We don't know. But as of July 1st, if you do not have GA4 set up, you will not have access to any new analytics data. So please make sure that you do have GA4 set up. If you do, one thing you'll notice, so if the number looks like this, 358581, like if it's just digits, that's GA4, and it means you have it set up properly. If you're still seeing UA, that's Universal Analytics, that means you do not have GA4 installed. Okay. Once you have GA4 installed, you'll see it's not very user-friendly here. There's a lot of data that is different than Universal Analytics, and I do not find it user-friendly at all. So I do have GA4 set up for every one of my accounts and my client accounts, but it's only because they may be using Mediavine or AdThrive or one of the ad networks that makes it required. When you do set up your GA4, the one thing you have to make sure you check is that in your admin, you're gonna go to data settings and look at data retention. So by default, guys, this is only set to 2 months, which means you would only retain 2 months of your analytics data. Make sure you're changing this to 14 months. Okay, a lot of people are not doing that, I'm noticing, so I just wanted to make you aware you need to change it to 14 months and then click Save. If you do not have GA4 set up and you're feeling overwhelmed, just reach out to me through my website at twodogs.media. And I'll do my best to help you out. I'm just charging a small fee just to get it set up and installed if you need help with that. I'm not helping with any setting up of reports or anything like that because it's just not that easy. So if you just need help getting it installed, just reach out to me. I'll be glad to help you. Now, what have I done? I don't look at analytics anymore. I live and die by Clicky. So this is clicky.com. One of the things I love about this, again, I have been a customer of his for a really long time. He never changes anything. This looks exactly the same as it did when I started with him years ago. There's no bells or whistles. It's just simple. It's intuitive. It gives me the data I need without doing anything. So this is the homepage. Okay, to register or create a new account, you just type in your name, your email, username and password. You'll create an account and then you'll go in and you'll set up your domains. So I'm gonna log in real quick to my account. And this is what the admin looks like. Okay, so you can see it's $120 a year. I got Pro Plus. There is several different plans. This one has, I believe, heat mapping and things. So I really wanted to make sure I had that. I can have 10 sites with up to 30,000 daily page views. So if you do have a lot of page views each day, it might get a little expensive, but in my opinion, it is absolutely worth it, because all you have to do is put in your URL, install a line of code in your file, in your website, and that's it. There's no setting up, there's no filters to create custom reports, nothing like that. So let's take a look at one of my sites. So here is what it looks like on a daily basis. This is what's going on today. You can see all your recent visitors, what country they're coming from, what time they came in, the pages that are most popular, what links are sending traffic to me, traffic sources. I'm getting 25%, I'm dropped down from yesterday, searches, direct links, social media, all the different countries, all the different pages, And same thing for any other one. This is my Two Dogs Media site. I don't get a lot of traffic to this site. I don't really push traffic here, but you can see the content. Okay, so I can easily see somebody downloaded my audit template. They looked at the checklist. Okay, and this is just for today. Now say I want to do last 60 days. I can do that. So I can see all the traffic in the last 60 days. I get a lot from YouTube, Facebook, LinkedIn, YouTube. I don't know what that is. I know what that is. That's a client. HubSpot, Trello. So I've got all this information about where my visitors are coming from, which is fantastic. Okay, you can dive in deeper. So for the last 60 days, I can get a better idea of, you know, who's sending what where. So I can see from YouTube, they came to my audit checklist. From Yahoo, they found my Query Hunter plugin, so I must be ranking for that. So all a really good amount of information here. You can see actions. Okay, if I click on this, it'll tell me all the actions they did on that page. Guys, I don't have to set anything up for this. In analytics, you have to set up a whole bunch of stuff to be able to see it this easily. So for me, my time is worth the $120 I'm spending. So I can see exactly every page that they accessed right through to downloading the spreadsheet. Four actions, same thing. I can see, you know, they refreshed a page a couple times and then they downloaded it. Okay. So that's one of the things I absolutely love. Action log. So you can see every action that was taken on the site. I can add custom data if I want. I don't really need to. It gives me everything I need. Most active visitors. So you can get a feel for, you know, if there's specific countries or specific IPs. Traffic sources, I can dig down deeper here. So if I want to see links, so over the last 60 days, these arrivals were from links from websites. Okay, I can see the engagement. So one action, obviously I want to see more engagement, so I have to work on that. But 1 to 10, 99 people take 1 to 10 actions. I would love to see more people taking more actions, but we'll get there. Spy. This is cool because I can see what people are doing on my website right now. Okay, so this person just left a few minutes ago after they downloaded their checklist. Let's go to a more active site. So if I do spy right now, I can see this guy right now is on my freeze-dried banana cake URL. Okay, but I can see all these different people have been on my website within the last few minutes, and I can see all the different things that they're doing. So you're getting a real live view of where they are right now on your site, which is really cool. It'll tell you the most popular content. Okay, so these are all my most popular content. You can see where they were before they got to that page, where they were after they were on that page. Okay, how many visitors came to that page in the last 60 days, average time on page. Total time for this page in the last 60 days was 8 days. So it's pretty funny to see that. You can go right to the URL from here. You can see where they're entering from. Okay, so they landed right here from Google search. They probably landed right here, coming to the home page. You can see what page they're exiting from. How many downloads you have going on. So these are all the downloads that are being made on the site. I don't have any events set up, but you can set up events for buttons and clicks and things like that. I don't have any set up, but this is a fantastic way to track call to actions, form completions, things like that. So there's a lot you can do there. And then there is searches. So you can see if there's any searches within your website. This is an amazing resource for finding new opportunities for content. So if you know like strong power cord knots, if I don't have an article specifically on that, I may want to write one. So I can, you know, I can click on this and figure out what page they landed on that they saw this and make sure it speaks specifically about that. This is hard to find in Google. Okay, so if they don't make it easy anymore. This will give you some keywords if they can find them. Okay. The search engines that are sending the most traffic. Google, Bing. Newest unique visitors, and then Sheer SEO. This is kind of cool that they integrate with Sheer SEO. I have used Sheer in the past as well. It's a pretty good tracking tool. I found it to be pretty accurate. I don't use it now, but it's something I may go back to. Then you've got links, so you can see the links that are sending traffic to your page. newest unique. Okay, so a lot of information here, guys, and all I had to do was enter my URL. Okay, different platforms, so you can see, you know, where you're being seen the most, so you can make sure you're optimized for that specific platform. So iOS and Windows are pretty evenly split for me. Screen resolutions, so I definitely want to make sure, you know, I'm well optimized for both of these resolutions. Hardware, pretty well split there as well. Local, just to make sure you're targeting the right country. Apparently I get traffic from everywhere for this one, but most is from the US, which is where I want it to be. Then you can target down. You can see regions, you can see cities, languages. So if you're doing local sites, this is a really great tool, even for narrowing down right to the local recent visitors map. So you can kind of just get a feel. So they have this really cool map. Goals, I don't have any goals set up because most of my sites I'm tracking right now are blogs. So goals, you can do split tests. You can do goals to track all different, whatever campaigns you're running, you know, to see how well they're doing. And then you've got your regular campaigns. If you're doing Pinterest or social, okay. There's an uptime check. I don't have this set up, so it'll let you know if there's any downtime on your website. And then there's just a section for your preferences. Okay, so you can delete. There's all different. This is where you get your tracking code. You can have reports automatically emailed to you, different alerts set up. So this is Get Clicky. Okay, and you can do you know, all different date ranges. Say you just wanted to see how well you did last month. 7,000 visitors. You can see 2 days ago. You can see just today. Okay. So there's a lot of different information that you can get in here. So this is Get Clicky. I hope you found this somewhat helpful. If you have any specific questions about it, let me know and I'll do my best to answer them. And I, like I said, I highly recommend it. There is an affiliate link in the description in case you do decide to test it out, but I can't say enough good things about it. It's affordable, it's easy to use, and it covers just about everything you would need to make smart business decisions. So any questions, let me know, guys, and have a great day.